Long ago, people would gaze up at the stars and tell stories of how they came to be. In some, they were gods and goddesses, and in others, they were intricate murals. I think part of why they did this is because as humans, we like explanations. We find comfort when things make perfect sense. I definitely fell into that trap researching this video on fenugreek. I wanted to understand whether the claims behind this herb had any evidence to them, and if so, how it worked. I eventually got to the point where I was emailing back and forth with some of the PhD researchers studying this herb right now. For this video on fenugreek, I'm going to lay out what the research studies have proven, and although the science hasn't totally figured out all of the interactions behind why it works the way it does, I'll still dive into a couple of theories. Before we get into the proven effects of fenugreek researchers have found, we need some background. Fenugreek is a herb that appearance-wise is similar to clover and native to the Mediterranean region, southern Europe, and western Asia. The herb is used as a spice in various traditional foods and also in traditional medicine. Many choose to make their own teas from the seeds, while some companies sell the herb in pill form as a dietary supplement. When people talk about the plant, it's important to note that there are different parts of the plant which are studied, as Dr. Beth Steeles explained to me. There are many different chemical compounds in both the fenugreek herb, the fenugreek seed, and also there are different extracts, some that contain the seed husk, and others that take the husk out before extraction. For example, tea made from the seeds of the herb has consistently proven to increase milk volume in breastfeeding women. A study published in the Journal of Alternative and Complementary Medicine had one group of new mothers ingesting tea brewed with fenugreek seeds at 3 cups per day. On the third day, they measured mean breast milk volume. The women drinking the tea produced a mean 73 milliliters versus the control group, which produced just 31 milliliters. They also found the babies of the fenugreek tea mothers got back up to their birth weight faster. For the guys watching this, apparently after babies are born, they actually lose weight before they gain it back. Don't worry, I didn't know that either. And in both women and men, there is talk of it promoting hair growth, which I will come back to a bit later. Here's where things get confusing, though. In recent years, manufacturers have been selling fenugreek as a testosterone booster. Now, I'm going to get this out of the way. Based on the evidence, it doesn't look like pure unaltered fenugreek alone in any way increases muscle and strength. Studies have, however, shown increases in libido in men, but testing for a rise in testosterone has been unreliable. When talking about testosterone, it's also important to mention another, even more potent hormone, dihydrotestosterone, or DHT. This hormone is similar to testosterone, but is far more potent in activating androgen receptors, the receptors on cells that cause men to display manly features. In our body, circulating testosterone is acted on by an enzyme, which turns it into this DHT. DHT is also one of the active hormones responsible for male and female pattern hair loss. DHT is anywhere between 2.5 to 10 times more potent than testosterone at activating androgen receptors in your body. And while studies on fenugreek have occasionally shown a mild increase in testosterone, these usually go hand in hand with a mild decrease in DHT. In one study, DHT levels in men dropped by 9%. It is thought that this occurs because something in fenugreek is inhibiting the alpha reductase enzyme, leading to a backlog in testosterone which isn't being converted into DHT. Which, in theory, could mean a slight benefit if you're suffering from male or female pattern hair loss. But this is also the only thing fenugreek does which can clearly be explained by measurable hormone changes. Just using a tiny testosterone increase and DHT decrease doesn't explain why people report their libido increasing. First of all, testosterone changes which have been detected are only minor, and secondly, the brain's androgen receptors primarily only respond to DHT and not testosterone. So if fenugreek means less DHT, if anything, shouldn't libido drop? Well, it turns out, as I said, things are just more complicated than that. But I didn't want to give up. I wanted to explain this for you guys. Dr. Steeles explained to me that there are multiple biochemical pathways working at once, and that libido is a complex thing, which she believes might be related to the ratio between many hormones, with testosterone being just one part of it. When you ingest fenugreek, it has many interactions with the bacteria in your gut, which can have a ripple effect throughout the body and an impact and normalizing effect on many hormones. I also know that the same protodiacerin found in tribulus can be found in fenugreek. It is very possible that fenugreek, like tribulus, is affecting or sensitizing the anabolic signaling pathways in the brain in ways other than simply raising hormone levels. Whatever the mechanism, evidence for a libido boost in men is pretty robust. More research will need to be conducted before scientists truly understand this mechanism. Something researchers are currently exploring more deeply are the anti-diabetic effects of fenugreek. It has been found that ingesting between 2 to 5 grams of fenugreek seeds help lower blood glucose levels and improve glucose tolerance, something helpful for diabetics and pre-diabetics. This could be in part due to the soluble fiber in the seeds slowing down digestion and absorption of carbohydrates. That's the explanation given by diabetes.co.uk. So to recap, studies have shown that women who ingest fenugreek while breastfeeding produce more milk. Men who ingest fenugreek report an increase in their sex drive. Both male and female pattern baldness are related to DHT levels, which fenugreek may slightly lower based on a few studies. To be clear though, no specific study has shown that fenugreek reduces this hair loss, so this is all theoretical. Through studies, it has also been shown to reduce blood glucose levels and spikes. If any of these benefits interests you, I encourage you to do your own research. As I said, there's a lot of unexplored territory when it comes to this herb. I don't usually like making videos on topics I don't fully understand, but my takeaway is that I don't think anyone fully understands this herb yet. If you enjoyed the video, consider subscribing. And as we inch closer to 2,500 subscribers, I'm planning a special treat for you guys. A new PR video, perhaps? Want to see my last video on a claimed testosterone-boosting herb, tribulus? Click here. Or see my last PR video, where I hit 1,000 subscribers and do a weighted pull-up with 160 pounds. I'll link to that as well. And as always, until next time, D-Man, signing off.